Welcome to IDES LABS. We are the best eminent and SAP training academy, totally based in Hyderabad, India. IDES LABS is delivering the price efficiency and the high quality of SAP e-learning for various trainees and consultants who are located across the globe. We are expert in services like SAP online training and also the corporate training on various SAP verticals like SAP technical and functional modules as such.
It is available in materials management, and we'll also see the linkage between different organization elements. Okay, so as you're working in SRM, so I guess you have an idea about this organization element. Your top level will be your client. After that, we can subdivide our client into different company code. Here, if we say talk about the company code is simply an independent accounting unit. Suppose if you have a one big enterprise and you want to know a profitability of each business. Suppose you have a one big enterprise. In that enterprise, you have a chemical vertical, pharmaceutical vertical, automobile vertical. So now if you want to know the profit of individual vertical, then these verticals, chemical, pharmaceuticals and automobile, can be created as company code. After that, third part comes, which is your plant. Plant is a location where your actual manufacturing activity will take place. See, plant is a one master which will be common to almost all modules. If you talk about PP, plant is mandatory. MM, plant is mandatory. SD, plant is mandatory. PM, plant is mandatory. PS, plant is mandatory. Okay, yes. So after that comes your storage location. Simply, storage location is a key which represent the exact location of a material, so that our tracking will be easy.
Yeah.
Now this is the one assignment. Okay, so my top label is company code. After that, I have in center row, I have my plant. See, 1000, 2000 is my plant. Here, one interesting thing is that 3000, 4000 is also my plant. The meaning of 3000 is regional office and 4000 is head office. Why I have created them as a plant? Because see, there are two type of plants. If we talk about the concept about plant, first is manufacturing plant, second call it logical plant. Okay. In logical plant, there won't be any manufacturing activities, but in order to track your expenses, in order, suppose in your regional office, definitely you are incur some kind of expenses in terms of stationery, in terms of electricity. Okay. So in order to capture all these expenses, you can create offices as a plant also, but that the nature of that plant will be logical. Okay. Similarly, if we talk about the some depots, in a similar way, you can create depot as a plant here.
Okay.
And port also. Now this is your, after that here, this is your last key which tells us about the storage location. Okay. Now here, each plant can be assigned to only one company code. Why? Because see, plant is our profit generating unit. Okay. So in our profit generating unit, we cannot distribute profit to different company codes. That's why each plant can be assigned to only one company code. See, the objective of any business is to generate profit. By now, if you want to generate profit, definitely you'll do some kind of transactions. So either that transaction will be in terms of physical goods or non-physical goods. So if we talk about the physical goods, that is your material. And if we talk about the non-physical goods, that is your services. Okay. So MM deals with the both areas, materials as well as services.
Yeah.
Apart from that, there are some organizational elements which are procurement process dependent. So one is your purchasing organization. Simply we can say purchasing organization is a group of people responsible for purchase. Okay. What happened in many organizations? Suppose the organization is dealing in many type of materials. What they generally prefer, they create one central purchase organization and central purchase organization, they make central purchase organization responsible for high value items, while their local plant purchase people will be allowed to purchase only low value items. Okay, like your major raw materials will be handled by central purchase organization because their contribution is big in your total expenses. Okay, then comes your purchasing group. Purchasing group is a simply a key responsible. It tells us about the person responsible for procurement. Okay, now I think you, yes, you're aware that if you talk about any module, so that module is again divided into three parts. First, we call it master data. Master data is a base data for your business processes. After that, data comes is your transaction data. If I give an example of transaction data, your production order, your sales order, your purchase requisition, purchase order, all these are transaction data. Now, if you have a master and on basis of a master's, you have done certain transaction, so definitely you have a data in your system. So on basis of this data, you can generate n number of report. So first one is master data, second is transaction data, and third one is your reporting. Okay, so we'll see in this manner. So this is one slide about the master data and procurement. Okay. If you suppose you want to purchase a air condition, okay, so first of all, what you go do, first of all, you'll fix up some specification of air condition in your mind. Okay, after that, you'll fix up one budget. Suppose you said, I want to buy air condition of Hitachi make only 1.5 ton. Okay, and it should be split. So this, what is this? Yeah. This is your specification. So we enter a specification in our material master. Okay, after that, what we think, after that, we go to market and try to find the best price available in market. Okay, so in this process, we visit different stores, we take quotations, we compare quotation, and after that, we finalize our vendor for procurement. Okay, so here your vendor master comes in picture, this one. And on basis of vendor master and material master, there is one record which is called in purchasing info record. Purchasing info record stores some detail which become mandatory for purchasing. We can generate purchasing info record manually, and we can also automate this process during the procurement.
Yeah.
So let us talk about the material master. So in material master, there are many views. These views are dependent on type of material. Okay, so this is one basic view. Here we define, here we enter our description of material, base unit of measure, unit in which we are going to handle this material. Then comes your material group. Material group is simply a grouping of same kind of material into one group, so that if you want to search any material, so suppose if you have a 100 type of LED TVs in your organization,
yeah,
and if you want to get a report, then one way is that you enter all 100 material reports. Other way is that you simply enter your material group and system will show you the complete list of your LED TVs. Okay.
Okay.
Then this is one view which is only MM relevant view. See, in material master, there are views which is module specific and there are some common views. So this is a module specific, MM specific view. Here we define a purchasing group. Purchasing group is simply, as I said, the person responsible for procurement of this material. Okay. Apart from that, here we can define one purchase value key. See, what is the role of buyer? If you try to understand the procurement process, so the role of buyer is to get material at right quantity, right price, and at right time.
Okay.
So for right quantity and right price, he'll have some tools like quotation, comparison, RFQ and all that. But what about the right time? Okay, for right time, definitely he has to take a follow-up with your vendors. Okay, so one way is that he simply get the detail from SAP and he is right to mail. other way is that you can automate this process by using this purchase value key. Here, okay, we can set a reminder label. Suppose I said I'll send a one alert as before 7 days of delivery by saying that okay, your delivery date is this much, be ready for dispatch. After that, if vendor is not able to submit, supply that material, it means the delivery date expired. In that case, I can set again second alert like 10 days after of delivery date expire. Okay, and all these kind of reminder and expeditors can be automated.
Okay.
Okay, so it reduces your load on your buyer. Okay, then comes your I'm just showing you the a few important things. Okay, so then comes your accounting. See, SAP, as you are aware that SAP is our integrated software. Whenever you do any kind of transaction, that transaction definitely will hit some other areas also. Okay, so whenever we perform any transaction, that cost of that transaction must be recorded in financial books of account. So this accounting view, we use this valuation class here as a bridge between material management and FI, finance team. Okay, so on with the help of this valuation class, system determine correct general ledger account for value posting. Right, after that, here is one price control indicator. See, what happened, we have a two type of price control. One is moving average price, second is standard price. Standard price is commonly used for your semi-finished material, finished goods, which you want to produce in-house. While for other or input material, your outside procurement, we keep moving average price. Okay, because see, suppose today you procured item at the cost of 10 rupees. Okay, tomorrow you again procured same item at the cost of 15 rupees.
To know more about the course with real-time implementation and scenarios, you are just a few clicks away to request us, and you can also contact us on our contact us media or directly like us on our Facebook, LinkedIn and Twitter so that we can keep you updated. Thank you for seeing this video.